The markets in Wall Street, you know, they're closed today, but we're open. Our competition isn't. U.S. futures, by the way, pointing to a big update tomorrow. So here's how you might want to set up your investments for tomorrow. Let's bring in Steve Dudash. He is IHT Wealth Management President. Futures are actually pointing up possibly 200 points. I think the overall question would be, does this mean that the market has finally found that bottom that we've been so desperately looking for?
That's a great question. I hope so. I don't know if anyone can say for sure that we found the bottom, but it looks like tomorrow's going to be very nice. We need maybe another 10 or 15 of those to get back to even on the year, but it's nice to see the overseas markets are starting to flatten out a little. Not flatten, they had a big day, but rebound pretty well. Good pointing to good signs for us at least tomorrow, and hopefully that'll mean that energy prices keep rising like they have the last 3 or 4 days, and we can see some end to the nonsense on that part of the market that has been adding so much uncertainty to our overall economy.
Well, Steve, I'm glad you brought that up because there's a report that's just come out today. It looks like it's unconfirmed so far, but sources are telling Reuters that the Saudis and the Russians may be meeting tomorrow to discuss the oil glut, to discuss the global glut in the market. That meeting, whether headlines come out or not, could have a big effect on oil and also equities as well.
Oh, yeah. I mean, and there's been a few of those reports in the last week or so of rumors of this meeting, rumors of that, and everyone denies it. But at the end of the day, oil prices got, what, to $26 a barrel? There's zero chance that is a sustainable level. Everyone, and I know people are talking about in the 10s and the 20s, there's no way, not only that companies can last at that price, but there's countries that will go out of business at that price as well. Look at Venezuela. They're going to be broke here pretty soon, and oil is a big reason why. And that will dry up some of the supply that we've had, the oversupply, that will then, you know, balance out a little bit better with demand, get our prices back to a little bit more normal stages, and we'll start seeing some stability in prices again.
You know, Steve, I have to put you on the spot a little bit. Last time you were on the show, you picked Chipotle. You like Chipotle.
Yeah.
The E. coli scare has really done a lot of damage to their earnings and the forecast and frankly, the name of the company, their reputation. Are you sticking with Chipotle now?
Well, when I was on the show, actually, it's up about 15% since the point when I was on the show at picking Chipotle. And I was also the same guy who told everyone to be selling it when it was at, you know, 30% higher than it is right now. I'll tell you a story, though, real quick. I'm in Chicago, downtown Chicago. There's 1,000 food places within a block of where I'm at. For months there, you could walk into Chipotle. Nobody was in the place. The other day, last week, it was 20 degrees out, freezing out, and there was a line out the door. No reason why there should be a line out the door if everyone's still afraid that they're going to die from E. coli and whatever on that. I really believe that we're seeing the bottom and the rebound. I know the dying.
Okay,
but
well,
rebounding on that.
I'm looking at the futures. I'm thinking about my moves tomorrow. What am I going to buy? What am I going to sell?
Yeah.
But you know what? A lot of the media names, we had a lot of the earnings for the media companies come out within the last week. And there was, you know, there's some worry, of course, about ESPN and with Disney's numbers. But overall, what do you think of the media space right now?
Okay, so the stock market obviously has been rough. So you need to look at some defensive positions. This year's political circus that's been going on is prime for the media people, including your company, to really take advantage of it. I mean, you've got Trump. Every time he says something crazy, your guy's stock goes up in price. You've got Sanders, the far extreme on the other side. You sprinkle in some Clinton circus that's always with them. And now with what's going on in the Supreme Court, I tell you what, if I'm looking at media stocks, that's one sector that should give us some stability and not have to deal with what energy prices are doing on a daily basis.
All right. Well, there you go. Steve Dudash, thank you very much.